Good evening and welcome to our Center for Scholars Senior Celebration as we honor the senior Abrego Future Scholars and Nicholas Academic Scholars. We are truly honored to have you as our guests as we celebrate our students and the program this evening. My name is Yahaira Tavad and I have the pleasure of serving as the director of the Center for Scholars. I want to start by sharing that we appreciate your participation today. We have worked with campus partners to provide a safe way to celebrate and honor these students and their accomplishments. We ask for your flexibility as we coordinate this program fully remotely. Should there be any technical or security concerns, we may stop the program and send a new link for you to rejoin the program. New links will be emailed to the scholars at their campus email accounts and posted on our Instagram account at CSUF Scholars. The Center for Scholars serves a remarkable group of resilient and ambitious students that come from diverse backgrounds. From their first day on campus, they are encouraged to get involved and become integral and well-rounded leaders in the Titan community. These Titans achieve their academic goals and develop their confidence and skills to become effective leaders, cohesive team members, and inspiring role models. We provide these scholars with a transformational experience for holistic growth through a diverse and inclusive environment, services, and opportunities. Our core values include collaboration, community, authenticity, compassion, and celebration, which is what Abrego Future Scholars and Nicholas Academic Scholars embody. Scholars, today we celebrate you because you have reached an important milestone in your lives. As first generation and college students, we understand the challenges you face to obtain your degree. Not only did you take on a full load of courses, but a lot of you had to maintain a job to support your family. You mentored and took care of your siblings while your parents were working hard to make ends meet. You were studying late night hours and making so many more immense sacrifices to make your dream a reality. All your hard work has finally paid off. The degree you have earned will give you a chance at opportunity and upward mobility for yourself and your family. You are the product of the love, support, and care that has been poured into you by your loved ones, donors, staff, and faculty. Being a graduating first generation and college student is an extraordinary achievement. And today you serve as role models and an inspiration to your family and communities. We have shared so many amazing moments with you in the center. For the past 4 years, the Center for Scholars team and I have witnessed your incredible growth. We have watched you all step out of your comfort zones and engage in leadership with your clubs, sports, Greek life, ASI, and in so many other ways. We jumped up with joy when you got accepted into graduate programs. Your courage to take risks, step out of your comfort zone, and do things you've never seen anyone in your family do before is inspirational. Every time you experience a difficult moment, you did not give up. You kept trying and empowering yourself as you discover your incredible potentials. Today, I see a group of scholars who are prepared to face the world. You have demonstrated that the impossible is very possible. The legacy you leave will continue to inspire many other future scholars. My hope for you is that you continue to challenge yourself and keep dreaming big. A very special aspect about AFS and NAC is your willingness to give back to your on and off campus community. This is what it means to be a Titan. How you engage as a community leaves us all in awe. I recall seeing students coming into the center with bags full of oranges from your trees or snacks that you wanted to contribute for the food pantry that your peers could benefit from. The level of compassion and empathy in which you give back is special. You certainly set an amazing example for everyone who gets to be in your presence. You remind us all to think beyond ourselves and find ways to make a difference in the world. We never imagined that we would have to celebrate you virtually during such a difficult time. And I completely understand the uncertainty many of you are experiencing. But just imagine when we are able to come out of our homes and the world reopens, we will be kinder, more loving, grateful, understanding, and appreciative of life and human connection. The class of 2020 will be the innovators who will create solutions that will help us navigate the world differently. You are the leaders that will rebuild the world with a great deal of intention and heart. I am absolutely confident that you are ready to take on the challenges you will face. And remember that you are never alone. You have a huge Titan family that is always ready and willing to support you. I want to take a few minutes to also acknowledge those who have supported you. Your success is partly due to the support of donors, staff, faculty, your peers, and your loved ones. Thank you to the families and loved ones for sacrificing so much to ensure that these scholars could be the first generation in your families to attend and graduate from college. Thank you to all the donors who continually support by providing scholarships that have made it possible for scholars to have incredible experiences at Cal State Fullerton. Thank you to President Virgie and Mrs. Virgie for all the love and support you have shown our scholars. And thank you to the Center for Scholars team. We have worked very hard to support you throughout the years. We have been there for you when you needed guidance, encouragement, a heart-to-heart conversation, life coaching, hugs, connection, laughter, and most importantly, celebrating you every time you achieve something. They truly pour a lot of heart into supporting you. Abrego Future Scholars and Nicholas Academic Scholars, we are going to miss you, but this is not goodbye. This is simply a farewell. We will see each other again. And remember that you are now alumni. And we are providing you a lifetime Alumni Association membership to stay connected. So don't forget about it. Congratulations, class of 2020. And best wishes to you all as you enter the next phase of your life. It is now my pleasure to introduce Julie Virgie, and she would like to share a few remarks with everyone.
Like I said in the chat, it is so good to see all of your faces. Some of you are smiling and some of you aren't smiling yet. I don't get that. This is a big day and we're celebrating you. We are so grateful to you. You have no idea. You help make Cal State Fullerton what it is. Your love, your tenacity, your willingness to work hard, your willingness to sacrifice. And we get so much from you, you have no idea. You have no idea. Because you are what makes Cal State Fullerton so amazing. It's not people walking around that look older than you, trust me, or way older than you like I am, but it's you. It's your energy, it's your tenacity, and your spirit. And I'm grateful to each and every one of you for making Cal State Fullerton such a cool place to be. I wanna thank all of the donors, because without the donors, there would not be Nicholas Scholars and Abrego Scholars. I think I see my buddy Cy on here, and Cy, I miss you. I miss Tina. I'm so grateful for what you have done at Cal State Fullerton and all the lives that you have helped mold and shape, and thank you so much for that. Students, I want to tell you, first of all, Fram is upstairs interviewing somebody. Otherwise, he would be sitting right next to me in that tree or in that building or whatever that's on the screen with me. He is very sorry that he's not here. I would be here anyway, but he's sorry he can't be here. So know that you've made a huge difference in our lives. We are better for it. I hope you're better. You feel better for being at Cal State Fullerton. You've got wings underneath your feet. I'm sorry, wind underneath your wings and underneath your feet, and you are going to fly and continue to fly high. We're so very proud of you. I always say I'm a proud mama, and that makes me the mom of 40,000 kids and 4 sons of my own. That's a lot of kids, but I'm grateful to be your proud mama and to infuse in you a little bit of love, just like our Center for Scholars does very, very well. I do hope that you feel that once a Titan, always a Titan. We might be shooing you out right now, class of 2020. That just means that you've done a great job and you're ready for the real, real world. And you are ready. You're very ready. And we're so proud of you. We're not telling you goodbye. We're just sending you off like a bird's out of the nest. So know that you're welcome back anytime. In fact, you're expected to come back and be a great Titan alum and come to baseball and come to lectures and come to things. This is your home. Never think that it's not. This is definitely your home. So please stay well, keep healthy, keep doing what you're doing, because you're also darn successful and your beautiful faces just make me so happy to see you all. So with lots of love, Titan family.
Thank you, Mrs. Burgey, for your remarks. We really appreciate you. And now it's my pleasure to introduce a message from our Associate Vice President of Student Affairs, Dr. Clint Michael Renault.
Congratulations, scholars. I am so thrilled to be a part of this celebration with you tonight. The fact is that none of us expected to be here. None of us signed up for this and the reality that we're facing right now. But what you have shown to all of us and what you have continued to demonstrate to the entire Cal State Fullerton community is that the Center for Scholars, as a scholar, you shine bright. You are powerful in your ability to be resilient, to demonstrate agility, and to face the demands of a world that is in flux right now. The reality is that all of us are dealing with uncertainty, and you are the ones who are helping keep everything calm and demonstrate how we are in terms of moving forward with a positive attitude and with making a difference in meaningful ways. And so, graduates, I know that you would desire this to look differently. I know that you would desire to celebrate differently. But as we conclude this semester, I just want to tell you that you are so integral to the success of Cal State Fullerton, and we salute you in so many ways. You, as a group, show us how to lead. You show us how to love. And you show us how to move with extraordinary kindness in tough times. The 4 years or longer that you've spent at Cal State Fullerton have been wonderful for us. We've enjoyed your company. We've enjoyed your friendship. We've enjoyed the ability to mentor you. And we know that while things right now seem really chaotic and maybe a little uncertain and scary, what we do know is this won't last forever. And so as a graduate, I want you to remember to hold your head high and to know you've got this. You've got this. You've come this far. You didn't come this far not to go even further. So please know that we are with you. We are rooting for you. We're cheering for you in every corner. And we ask that as you go into the world, remember that as a Titan, what you represent are the principles of inclusion, equity, integrity, truth. And know that maximize your humanity. In every space that you encounter, try to maximize your humanity in order to help those whose voices are often pressed into the margins. Help those who don't have a seat at the table. Help those that when you know you have a longer table, you know that it's important to extend the table and not build a higher wall. And so we want to thank you for representing the values of this campus. We want to thank you for being inclusive, and we want to thank you for taking what it for having what it takes as a Titan, as a scholar, to push us forward, to make us think in ways that society hasn't thought before, to challenge us, to keep us on our toes, and to always recognize the humanity in others around us. And that's what makes you so special. You do it, and you do it every time. Any of us that walk into the Center for Scholars know that when we walk into that center, we feel such heartfelt energy. We receive such love when we come into that space. It's some of our favorite spaces to be in. And it's because of you, the scholars. And so we ask that you please just do whatever you can do from whatever seat you sit in life to elevate all that you can and take everything that you've learned for these years at Cal State Fullerton and share it. Our responsibility is that when someone holds the door open for us, we have to turn around and hold the door open for someone else. And we hope that you'll do that. We hope that you will pull along the next generation of scholars, that you'll serve as a remarkable alum of this program, that you will want to mentor the next generation, that you will want to support and give back when you can. And we don't want you to forget about us. Know that we're here to serve as your cheerleaders. We're here to serve as your motivators, encouragers, mentors, references. Whatever you need from us, please let us know. We wish you nothing but the best. We wish you health. We wish you love. We wish you much success. So congratulations, graduate. You have earned this. You've deserved it. Have a wonderful, remarkable, amazing life.
Thank you for those remarks, Dr. Renaud. I will now introduce Jamie Hamilton, Assistant Director of the Center for Scholars, and she will be introducing our senior class.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I would like to present the senior class of the Abrego Future Scholars and the Nicholas Academic Scholars programs. These students that we are honoring here tonight are among the very best of the 2020 senior class at Cal State Fullerton. Our senior scholars have done amazing things throughout their time at Cal State Fullerton, and we want to tell each of them how very proud we are of their accomplishments. Your presence at CSUF has made a tremendous contribution to the faculty, staff, and students who you have met and worked with. I can recall fondly time spent with you all in the center, talking about your classes, financial aid, talking about experiences you've had as first-generation college students, going to events, hearing your stories, and learning from you all. This evening, as we welcome our graduates, you will see a picture of them represented on the screen with their bio. Yahida Tovar, Darcy Anderson, our senior coordinator, and myself will be alternating, introducing the students and reading their biographical statements. Tonight, we will start with the Abrego Future Scholars. Anthony Abasayed, Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration, concentration in Entrepreneurship.
Jocelyn Aguilar, Bachelor's of Science in, Jocelyn will graduate Cal State Fullerton with a Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development. She has been part of the Dean's List and participated in the Abrego Future Scholars Program. During college, she interned at Miller's Children's Hospital in Long Beach as a child life specialist. Jocelyn volunteered at Kaiser Permanente with more than 150 hours and has received a certificate nursing assistant certification. As part of her senior internship, she worked with high-risk children at Grandma's House of Hope and was able to see the impact that early intervention had on children. After graduation, she plans on attending nursing school to become a registered nurse interested in pediatrics.
Amy Ariza. Amy is graduating with a degree in child and adolescent development with a focus on elementary school settings. Her experience at CSUF involved exploring everything the school offered, like the Center for Scholars, which has taught her to become a better leader. She also got to be an EOP student, where she learned resources that the school offered, and the Center for Careers in Teaching, which gave her the guidance she needed to become a teacher. She got great advice from her mentor from the peer mentoring program. Her journey has been amazing with memorable professors who have pushed her out of her comfort zone, which has made her a better Titan. She will be returning to CSUF to finish her credentials in teaching and getting her bilingual certificate in Spanish.
Paul Barquin, Bachelor of Arts in Communication with a concentration in advertising.
Alba Maria Barrios, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration, concentration in Finance.
Jacqueline Benitez. Jacqueline graduated in fall 2019 with a Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. During her time at CSUF, she participated in the Abrego Future Scholars Program and as a student advisor in Hermanas Unidas, a Latinx organization that is dedicated to the empowerment and advancement of women through community service, academic success, and social networking. She received the ASI Dreamer Scholarship and the Poder de la Mujer Scholarship 3 times from her organization. During her junior year, she attended a summer research opportunity program at Michigan State regarding architectural, engineering, and construction teams and the impact it has on team effectiveness. Jacqueline presented this research at several conferences and became a published author. After graduation, she plans to work with organizations to research ways to increase productivity and overall effectiveness in academia, government, and community platforms.
Kia Bustamante, Bachelor of Arts in Ethnic Studies, concentration in Chicana-Chicano Studies. Kia will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Chicano Studies. With support from her beautiful family, she has been able to have a successful journey as a Titan. Throughout her 4 years as a Titan, she has been part of the Bold Women Leadership Network, Bridge Up Scholar, Innovation Scholar, and an Abrego Future Scholar. After her graduation, she will be attending a Master's in Psychology graduate program at Southern New Hampshire University.
Maria Aleida Cano. Maria graduated cum laude in the fall with a Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration with concentrations in Accounting and Finance. She was a member of Accounting Society for most of her time at Cal State Fullerton and was a recipient of the Abrego Future Scholars Dreamer Book Scholarship. During her studies, she worked as a tutor focusing on accounting subjects, but always made sure to pick up an interesting subject as well. Maria plans to dedicate herself to studying and passing her CPA exams within the next couple of years and hopes she can learn a lot and grow in her upcoming role as a GES tax consultant with Deloitte.
Santiago Chamu will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development.
Kaziah Catherine Schulde, Bachelor's of Science in Health Science and a minor in Sociology. Kaziah will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Health Science and a minor in Sociology. During her time at Cal State Fullerton, she was a part of the Abrego Future Scholars Program For the last 3 years, she served as a sexual health chair and vice president of the Peer Health University Network. She was also in the Public Health Honor Society, Eta Sigma Network, Gamma, excuse me, and a student health advisory committee. During her senior year, Keziah completed an internship with St. Jude Hospital in the HMR Weight Management Program. This program provides individuals with the tools necessary of how to make healthy eating choices. After college, Keziah plans to pursue a master's degree in public health.
Anthony DeLoya. Anthony will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice.
Angelica Escobar. Angelica graduated cum laude in January 2020 with a Bachelor of Science in Health Science. She was a member of the Abrego Future Scholars Program, where she also became a peer mentor for the 2018-2019 student cohort. Angelica studied abroad in Guadalajara, Mexico. During college, she volunteered at St. Jude Hospital and also contributed to the CSU WRPI Community Water Program and the nonprofit organization Kid Healthy. Angelica plans to gain more experience before pursuing a professional degree in public health.
Mariana Fitz-Jimenez. Mariana will be graduating with a bachelor's degree in public health with a concentration in general studies. While at CSUF, she was part of the Abrego Future Scholars Program and was active on campus with the orientation and outreach and recruitment teams. As an orientation leader and team member, she spent her summers welcoming thousands of new Titans on campus. She was one of the student coordinators for the orientation team for the summer of 2018 and represented CSUF at the NOTA Region 2 conference. For the past 2 years, Mariana has volunteered over 200 hours at the St. Jude Medical Center. In her senior year, she became a clinic and birth intern and assigned at the birth center and home births, assisted. Mariana plans to apply to nursing programs to become an RN in the labor and delivery department.
Johanna Flamer will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Liberal Studies.
Herman Garcia will be graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Human Services.
Carla Garcia will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration and Accounting. Sonia Gomez will be completing a Bachelor's of Science in Human Services.
Centessa Guizar will be receiving a Bachelor's of Science in Civil Engineering.
Natalie Garola will be receiving a Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice.
Kenya Fabiola Guzman Hidalgo, Bachelor's of Arts in Science in Public Health and a Bachelor's of Arts in American Studies. Kenya will graduate with these degrees, and she is participating in the Abrego Future Scholars Program. Additionally, she has been a member of Sigma Kappa since fall 2018. During her college years, she was involved in serving the community by volunteering at various hospitals. She's currently a volunteer at the Children's Hospital OC, St. Jude Medical Center, UCI Medical Center, and Kaiser Permanente Anaheim. Her career goal is to become a physician, so after graduation, Kenya plans to begin her journey applying to medical school.
Guillermo Hernandez Perez will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration and a concentration in Finance. And he will also be receiving a second Bachelor's of Arts in Spanish.
Jetsiri Hernandez began at CSUF as an Abrego Future Scholar and will be finishing her time with a Bachelor of Science in Health Science. During some of her time at CSUF, she was a student assistant in the Department of Educational Leadership and one of the tutors for a STEM summer program for aspiring teachers. It was through these experiences that she was able to connect with the mentors and improve her leadership skills. Jatsiri later became the president of the Latino Medical Student Association for pre-medical Latino undergraduate students at CSUF after being a member and realizing her desire to pursue a medical degree. Jatsiri is also conducting health disparities research under the mentorship of Dr. Shanna Charles, where she has been able to better understand the healthcare gaps that exist in underserved communities. After graduation, she plans to take a year off to better prepare her application to apply to an MD program, where she hopes to also incorporate health disparities research.
Carla Leon, who is also a Nicholas Academic Scholar, will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development.
Jasmine Lopez. Jasmine is obtaining a Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Art with a concentration in Entertainment Arts/Animation. She was part of the founding committee for the Women in Animation at Cal State Fullerton Club for spring 2019. Carla is interning at a nonprofit called Power Speaks Louder, where she will continue to intern after graduation. She has received a scholarship to attend the Haku Annual Conference in Miami and to the Circle of Change Conference. Her plans after graduation, besides interning in PSL, is to apply to Pixar, Nickelodeon, Disney TV, and any animation studio. Carla also plans to apply for a job in her local district for college to have income and freelance.
Natalie Lopez. Natalie is currently majoring in communications with an emphasis in public relations and minoring in business marketing. She became an active member of Zeta Tau Alpha fraternity, which provided her with ample opportunities for personal growth, as well as time management and team collaboration skills. Furthermore, she joined the Public Relations Student Society of America, which enhanced her networking skills and created long-lasting relationships. Natalie has been honored with having her name on the Dean's List. She hopes to utilize all the wonderful things she learned throughout her 4 years at CSUF in her future endeavors. Natalie is currently studying for the July LSAT and then will be going to apply to law schools in Southern California for the fall 2021 semester.
Evelyn Martinez will be earning a Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Art with a concentration in illustration.
Nancy Martinez Gonzalez. Nancy will graduate with a Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. During her time at CSUF, she participated in the Abrego Future Scholars Program, where she had the benefit to receive an additional scholarship through a partnership with the university and the Mexican consulate. She was involved in professional student business organizations as the vice president of corporate relations for the Association of Latino Professionals for America and as a member of the Accounting Society. During her last semester in college, she gained experience in her field through an audit internship with a local firm. Nancy plans to gain further experience to expand her skills and knowledge in a career in public or governmental accounting.
Elba Martinez Sanchez, Bachelor's of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Brittany McNair will be receiving a Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Leslie Melendez. Throughout her 4 years at CSUF, Leslie has been an Abrego Future Scholar and will graduate with a Bachelor of Science in Kinesiology. She earns the Dean's List several times throughout many semesters at Fullerton. She was also part of the university's Honors Program, SHIPA, and KSA. Leslie dedicated her time to building her career outside of CSUF by gaining as much hands-on experience as she could. She maintained two jobs while attending Fullerton full-time. She obtained her CPT certification and started leading group exercise classes for the city of Los Angeles, all the while she was working at a physical therapy clinic as an exercise specialist. After graduation, Leslie will be completing her prerequisite courses at a community college. Then she will be applying to a master's entry-level nursing program.
Jaylene Mendoza, Bachelor's of Science in Human Services with a concentration in mental health. Jaylene will be receiving her Bachelor's of Science degree in Human Services with her concentration in mental health. Throughout her time at CSUF, she has served as a public relations co-chair for the Human Services Student Association and a peer mentor for the College of Health and Human Development and a Camp Titan counselor. Jaylene had the honor to receive the Mexican Consulate Scholarship, made the Dean's List, and was a guest speaker at the 2019 Hispanic Scholarship Golf Tournament. She was happy to share that all her hard work and dedication, she will continue her education this upcoming fall at California State University, Long Beach, pursuing a master's degree in social work.
Jennifer Mendoza. She will be receiving a Bachelor's of Science in Human Service.
Erica Monjares Gallegos will be receiving a Bachelor of Science in Child and Adolescent Development.
Emily Montenegro, Bachelor's of Science in Human Services.
Jordan will be receiving a Bachelor's of Arts in Women and Gender Studies. Jordan began her career at Cal State Fullerton in the fall of 2015. During her freshman year, she began interning at the Women and Adult Reentry Center. In her role there, she facilitated discussion groups aimed at empowering Latinx students on campus. Later, Jordan began working for the College of Education's Elementary Education Department. This past year, she earned her degree in Women's Studies, and she is now looking to pursue a career in academic counseling or teaching. Her major gave her tremendous insight into the radical changes that need to occur within the education system. Her hope is to be a force of change that demands inclusion and equity for all.
Sarah Nguyen. During her time at CSUF, Sarah was an Abrego Future Scholar and will graduate as a health science major with a psychology minor. She served as the Vice President of Communications for Sigma Kappa for one term, an Inner Club Council Representative and Secretary for Kinesiology Student Association for one term each. In her last year, Sarah participated in Dr. Roberts's Learning and Memory Research as a research assistant and hopes to discover simple forms of memory in larval zebrafish. Following the completion of her undergraduate studies, she hopes to gain more clinical experience as an applied behavioral analyst technician and pursue a career in social work or mental health.
Minjan Edward New, Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration with a concentration in finance. Edward is a proud Abrego Future Scholar who majored in business with a concentration in finance. Throughout his 3 years in college, he has been a member of the Abrego Future Scholars Student Association, Business Honors Member, Beta, the Alpha Psi International Honors Society, and been in the University Honors Program. Edward has served as the founder and president of the Abrego Future Scholars Student Association. After this term, he has served both as the executive vice president and in the president position for BAP. Edward strives to be a CEO for one of the bulge bracket banks in the world, and he will be starting his career with JP Morgan and Chase.
Stacy Elizabeth Valencia Bollinger. Stacy will be receiving a Bachelor's of Arts in Communication Disorders. As a communicative science and disorders major at Cal State Fullerton, Stacy has been involved in various organizations on and off campus. She has been in the Student Veteran Association, ABLED Advocators, STAMPS, NSSLHA, Craft Beer, Wine, and Homebrew Advocacy Club, and the Titan Warrior Wellness Program. In the community, Stacy has been involved with the American Legion Post 132 and Team Red, White, and Blue. She was awarded certificates of appreciation and certificates of recognition from on and off campus organizations, also congressional, city, county, and Senate recognition awards. As for her future goals, Stacy plans to attend graduate school to become an audiologist.
Elizabeth Perdomo. Elizabeth will be graduating CSUF with a Bachelor's of Science in Human Services, focusing on persons with disabilities. During her time at Cal State Fullerton, she joined various clubs, including Geography Club, Street Club, Adventure Club, and was part of the Abrego Future Scholars Program. She made the Dean's List frequently. Elizabeth interned for Growth Opportunities through Athletics, Learning, and Service for 2 semesters and the Mental Health Association Peer Mentor Program for another semester. After college, she plans to gain more experience to become a child life specialist. Ultimately, Elizabeth wishes to broaden her knowledge of children with disabilities before attending graduate school.
Noelle Placido, Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration with a concentration in marketing.
Brandon Quintero, Bachelor's of Science in Kinesiology.
Hiro Ramirez will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration with a concentration in Finance.
Alina Ramos, Bachelor's of Arts in Sociology and Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice.
Gabriela Regalado, Bachelor's of Human Services, concentration in Mental Health. Gabriela was born and raised in Mexico City. She immigrated to California in 2005. She is a mother of 2 amazing children. Gabriela will graduate from Cal State University Fullerton with a Bachelor's of Human Services with an emphasis in mental health. After graduation, she will be attending the Master's of Science degree in Education and Counseling program at Cal State Fullerton. Academically, Gabriela would like her career to approach low-income, Spanish-speaking and immigrant people who are facing a challenging time in their lives. She wants to be a productive person in this multicultural country and continue being a proud Mexican, representing her beautiful Latin heritage.
Christina Segovia will be graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in Sociology.
Claudia Serrato will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Liberal Studies.
Alpha Sortia, Bachelor's of Science in Human Services. Alpha will be a first generation graduate from Cal State Fullerton come May 2020. Her time at Cal State Fullerton has been amazing in finding what she is passionate about. Being a human services major, she cannot wait to go out and help out her community. All of the friendships with her classmates and professors she will carry with her after leaving Cal State Fullerton. Alpha cannot wait to see what the future holds and keep on representing Cal State Fullerton.
Lorena Valencia will be graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in English and a minor in Natural Sciences. Coming from one parent who received their high school degree and another received a GED, getting her Bachelor of Arts in English with her minor is amazing for both Lorena and her family. The fact that she has recently been accepted to UCI's master/credential program makes this all that much sweeter. She thanks God.
Efrain Velasquez. During his time at CSUF, Efrain was part of the Cycling Club and the Criminal Justice Student Association. Throughout his college career, he had to work full time, so he was limited on the clubs he could join. Efrain began his freshman year pursuing a bachelor's in electrical engineering, but after he completed an assessment with the Career Center, he knew he was in the wrong field. The field that he belonged in was criminal justice. His career goal is to work with a law enforcement agency. To better prepare himself, he has trained with peers every Friday morning, along with campus police officers and Fullerton police officers.
Rosa Victor, Bachelor of Arts in English.
Jasmine G. Viramontes will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration with a concentration in Finance and Business Analytics. Jasmine was a member of the Business and Data Analytics Club, was on the Dean's Honors List, and a participant of the Abrego Future Scholars Program.
And now we will recognize our Nicholas Academic Scholars. Adrienne Cristiano, Bachelor's of Arts in Psychology.
Nancy Casales, Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development. Nancy's time at Cal State Fullerton has been a journey filled with many memories that she will cherish forever. She was in the NAC Scholars Program for some time. She was a teacher's aide at the Children's Center on campus. Nancy was also placed on the Dean's List in the College of Health and Human Development as a result of her academic achievement. She will graduate with a Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development. After graduation, Nancy plans to continue to gain more experience in the child and adolescent field before pursuing her MA in education.
Giovanni Garcia will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Kinesiology.
Eduardo Guaipa, Bachelor's of Arts in Business Administration, concentration in Accounting. Graduating with these degrees, Edward also ran Division I cross country and track for a year for Cal State Fullerton. He would like to thank the coaches, his friends, and family for the support he has received over the years. His next step is to study for the CPA exam and to work in the field of public accounting.
Xochitl Lagunas, Bachelor's of Arts in Communication, concentration in Journalism.
Valeria Magdaleno, Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice. As a first-generation college student, Valerie will be receiving her Bachelor's of Arts degree in Criminal Justice. During her time at CSUF, she was part of the Human Services Student Association and volunteered in numerous agencies. She got involved with the Fullerton Police Department and gained skills that will help her achieve her career goal. To add on, Valerie participated in the U.S.-Mexico border, where she visited the U.S. Customs and Border Protection in Pine Valley. She gained further knowledge in her field by studying abroad in Sydney, Australia, and going to the District Criminal Court in New South Wales. After all her hard work, she will continue to pursue a career at the Fullerton Police Department and eventually apply for the FBI.
Clarissa Mendez, Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice.
Maria Ramos will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Kinesiology.
Elizabeth Vargas, Bachelor's of Science in Kinesiology.
Alejandra Vasquez, Bachelor's of Arts in Political Science.
Maria del Socorro Vasquez will be graduating with a Bachelor's of Science in Child and Adolescent Development.
Jacqueline Vergara, Bachelor's of Arts in History and Bachelor's of Arts in Women's Studies. With that, we congratulate all of our scholars. You all can see them all. We are now going to highlight a video compiled by the Center for Scholars commemorating the scholars' time here at CSUF and the relationships they've created.
Do you remember days on our old block? Messing with our neighbors, who called the cops. Could've swore that you and me could get away with anything. We lay on the grass all day talking, cause we snuck out of class when no one was watching. I remember you and me, yeah, I remember everything.
one of our fellow senior scholars, has recorded a speech to share with her peers.
Hi, my name is Amy Ariaza. I am a Chatham major, and I'm from the program from Abrego, and I'm going to be saying some words. Hopefully you guys enjoy them. We're all gathered here today to graduate. Yay! We did it! We got ourselves this far through our journey. All the struggles, the staying up late, running late to class, running to class, days only eating boring old sandwiches that have come to the end, that's come to the end for now. They were all worth it because we did it! We graduated! We have degrees that will take us far. And now that we have made it this far, it shows we can do it anything. We put our brains and soul on it. So thank you to our beds, teachers, Starbucks, YouTube videos, and energy drinks that helped us get this far. We couldn't have done it without them. And the journey begins with opportunities that are wide open. And from now on, not to be afraid of the unknown, because the unknown is what gives us a challenge and bravery. So Titans, we are fighters till the end, and head up high and be so proud. Hooray! We graduate.
And now we have some messages from some of our community partners, our Center for Scholars staff, and more.
Congratulations, Abrego Future Scholars and Next Scholars. You all did it. It has truly been such an honor to work with you all during your time at CSUF. For some of you, it may have been since the beginning of your time at CSUF, and for others, it may have just been through the series of emails that I've been sharing with you over the past semester. You all have overcome so much to make it to this point, and you should all be so proud of yourselves. Take everything that you have learned and share it with those coming after you. Thank you so much for allowing me to be part of your experience, and we will miss seeing you in the center.
Hey, my name is John. I just want to say congratulations on making it this far, closing a chapter in your life, and opening a new chapter in your life. Good luck on your goals and endeavors. You got this.
Hi, Center for Scholars Class of 2020. I just wanted to take a moment and congratulate you on this incredible accomplishment. I am so fortunate and thankful to get to work with each and every one of you every day in the Center for Scholars. And I extra look forward to hearing about all the incredible and amazing changes you bring to the world, because I know, without a shadow of a doubt, you're absolutely going to change this world. I wish you all the best in your futures. May they be full of love, joy, adventure, laughter, and prosperity. And please remember to visit. Congratulations again, Center for Scholars Class of 2020, and go Titans!
Hey, Center for Scholars Class of 2020, this is Alex Osorio, your CAPS liaison, and I just wanted to congratulate the Class of 2020. I wish you much success, send you lots of love, and pray that all your dreams come true. Remember that you already have everything you need within you to become the person you want to be. And remember to seek out your passion, because when you truly find your passion, you will never work another day in your life. Congratulations once again. Take care, and we'll miss you guys. Congrats.
Hi, this is Miguel Reyna, retention specialist for the Center for Scholars. This message is for all of the seniors that make up the Center for Scholars family. Wow, I want to congratulate you and your loved ones for the amazing accomplishment that you have achieved. Just like a Titan is supposed to do, you have reached higher, and I'm sure we are all very immensely proud of you.
Hello, I want to say a big congratulations to all the Abrego Future Scholars and Nicholas Academic Scholars for achieving this great milestone in your lives. I'm sure this accomplishment will only be the first of many. I know that everyone at the Center for Scholars shares my excitement and are looking forward to see all of the great things you all will continue to do.
Hello everyone, my name is Sia Abrego and I'm delighted to have this opportunity to congratulate the class of 2020. These are very difficult times for us, but it doesn't take away from this memorable day in your lives. What makes me very proud of you is that I know how hard you have worked to get to where you are today. Along the way, you have made many sacrifices. I'm sure there were days that tested your will to continue. But here you are, reaching a major milestone in your life. And you want to share this moment with all who helped you get here. Let's all congratulate your parents, your aunts, uncles, siblings, teachers, friends, and of course the Center for Scholars, who supported you and were your biggest cheerleaders along your journey. Un abrazo fuerte to all of your support network. I truly believe there is nothing you can't do. You have learned that challenges are nothing but opportunities for new discoveries and collaborations. But remember, don't let any person diminish you, and don't let fear paralyze you. Your education, your system of support, your determination, and belief in yourself will strengthen you. One thing is clear to me is that California needs you. It is through you that California will survive the health and economic crisis we are in. I am so proud that each of you joins a powerful family of Cal State Fullerton, living and working, making consequential changes throughout California and the world. You forever have our support. You forever have our respect. Always keep reaching higher. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hi, my name is Rosalina Davis, and I am so excited to be able to give you a message on your graduation. I am also a first generation graduate of Cal State Fullerton, and that is just something that changed my life totally, because it gave me so many opportunities that I wouldn't have had I not gone through the whole process. And Cal State Fullerton is an amazing institution. I'm sure you have built a lot of relationships, and with the support of your parents and your friends and all the staff and faculty at Cal State Fullerton, you've gotten to this point where you are at graduation. Unfortunately, I know it's heartbreaking that you're not going to be able to go through commencement, but the silver lining is that you did achieve your graduation status, and I believe that you're going to do wonderful things in the future. So I am truly, truly excited about your graduation, and I hope that you have a tremendous amount of success in the future, and just really wishing you the best. So congratulations, muchas felicidades.
Hello. First and foremost, I hope this message finds you and your loved ones safe and well. It would have been so much better for me to be there in person with you. On behalf of the Cal State Fullerton Hispanic Scholarship Golf Tournament Committee, who have given of their time and resources over the years to create opportunities for you as scholars, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate each and every one of you for your tremendous accomplishment as graduates of Cal State Fullerton. Your hard work, dedication, discipline, and sacrifice have truly paid off, and you have earned your degrees. However, please recognize that behind the scenes, you also had an administration, staff, and counselors who were there to provide you the necessary resources to help you achieve success. It is our hope that you will carry on their spirit, dedication, and passion to pay things forward so that those who follow in your footsteps will also have a fighting chance. Again, I want to congratulate you and wish you nothing but success in your future endeavors. And please know that Cal State Fullerton will always be there for you. Good luck to you and your families. May God bless you.
Hi, Next Scholars. Congratulations on your great accomplishments of graduating from Cal State Fullerton. I wish that we could be in person celebrating all the many accomplishments that you've been able to get to in the last 4 or 5 years that you've been there. All the hardships that you went through, all the long nights, all the tests that would never end, managing home and all the many things that, you know, come your way, responsibilities with our parents, all those things that were just equally instructive as that which you learned in the classroom. All of that, through it all, you did it. You got to this point. Maybe it felt like it was gonna be a very, very long way when you first started, but in reality, when you look back and you bask in all of it, I hope that you celebrated all the good and the bad, because you learned a lot and you grew a lot from it all. Right now, things may be just a little bit tough because of the pandemic and everything that's going on, but know that just like you managed to overcome all the other hardships as you reflect upon your life, this too will be one of those things that you've conquered, and in due time we'll be able to look back and say, okay, we learned something from that and how can we be better. And in due time we can get together in person and celebrate all the wonderful things that you did in your time at Cal State Fullerton. I'm just sorry we can't do it right now. However, from the bottom of my heart, muchas felicidades a ustedes, everyone, your family, for everything that you've accomplished. I can't wait to see you in person and give you a big hug without social distancing. Miss you all, and hope to see you soon. Adios.
Hi, Next Scholars. Congratulations. You did it. You've accomplished something that very few do. And for that, I wanted to say a big congratulations to all of you. Please know that, you know, we're still here for you in this next chapter of your lives. I know there's a lot of uncertainties, a lot of scary moments, a lot of doubtful moments, but know that you're going to get through this. Know that we all are going to get through this, and we're still here to support you and whatever you need. I wanted to say a special thank you to the Center for Scholars for helping you out as well. Together, we've been doing a lot of work to guide you as best as we can, and please know that we're still here and we still want to help you. I hope that you get involved with the Alumni Association. I know that we've been trying to get that up and running. We are going to be meeting the last Friday of every month. And we want to be able to better support you, you know, even after you graduate college. So we're still here. So for that, I leave you with another big congratulations, and hopefully when we see each other we can do a little mini celebration. All right, for now I bid you farewell, good luck, and congratulations again.
Well, this concludes our program. Thank you for joining us this evening and celebrating our students. Thank you for your commitment, dedication, and passion. Seniors, I look forward to engagement, your engagement as active alumni, and I am truly thankful for your gift of leadership, passion, and dedication to Cal State Fullerton. Thank you everyone for attending, and have a good evening.
We will now be opening up and inviting the attendees to join us as panelists and having a virtual waiting room. Please hold on while the staff adds you to our group. You can also leave messages for the students in the chat box as well.
You can unmute yourself too if you want to say anything.
I just fixed the feature, so now you can unmute yourself.
Oh, there you go. Now you can unmute yourselves.
I just wanted to say thank you guys for supporting us in our journey. I know I definitely wouldn't be where I'm at today if it wasn't for you guys. So thank you. And I will keep in touch with you guys because I'm definitely going to need some advice. And also a special thank you to Kanita too, because she's put a lot of time and effort with us and basically became our mom whenever we needed anything. So thank you, Kanita. You really impacted all of us.
It's my pleasure, friend. We will miss you dearly, but you know where to find us, so please come and visit, okay?
I want to give special thanks to Jamie and Kanita. I would always go bug them every day. Every time I had a question or a doubt, I'd be in your office. I'm like, I think I have this. And then you guys would always calm me down and help me with all my answers and figure it out. And then every time I had doubts about leaving school or if I should continue, I would go talk to you guys. And then hearing your experiences, it helped me so much. So I really appreciate everything you guys have done for me. I'm very grateful.
Thanks, Amy. We're proud of you and hope to see you at the Starbucks in the library one day soon.
Likewise, I think I'm going to miss our Starbucks chat.
Of course, I'm going to go just to visit you guys and just have a Starbucks chat. Thank you.
I would like to say a couple words real quick. Hey everyone, Danny, former Center for Scholars staff. You know, for the students that I was able to see, you know, over the last 4 years, I gotta say it really brings tears and emotions to me to be able to see you grow, you know, over the last 4 or 5 years, however long you were here. This job, like, y'all make it so rewarding. And I'm so proud of y'all. Y'all really truly embody, you know, just how the most beautiful form of resistance, which is just growing. So continue growing, continue fighting, don't give up. Whatever it is that you want out in the world, go get it, it's yours. It's an honor, it was a privilege to serve you all. And I love every single one of y'all. So congratulations one more time.
Thank you, Danny. We miss you too.
I just wanted to give a special thank you to everyone who works at the Center for Scholars. Special thank you to Yahaira, Jamie, Kanita, and Danny for always being the first one there to answer any questions that we had. I know I speak for the entire Abrego Future Scholars program that you guys have helped tremendously the past 4 years. Thank you to our donors.
Andrea, I think you got frozen. So hopefully you can come back and finish your warm thoughts in regards with us.
I wanted to give a special shout out to Kanita. Being the oldest in my family is kind of difficult because I feel like sometimes it's hard to have some guidance. So you definitely helped me out through my entire CSUF journey. I also want to give a special shout out to Juliana, who's watching, the orientation team. Definitely learned a lot from them. And a mi familia de Mexico, muchas gracias por verme. And for all my family that's joined here today in this afternoon. Thank you so much.
I just want to take this time kind of to like just to thank everybody. Each one of you, God, I graduated last semester and I didn't realize how much I missed all you guys. You guys became like a second family while I was at school, because there was days when I was at school over 12 hours a day just cracked my class into 2 days. And you guys were my second family, and I appreciate all of you so much for everything you've done just to help us along this path in school. And when this is all over, I am going to visit you guys. So, and just to the rest of the class, man, things are uncertain right now. We can't admit that. Things are very uncertain for each of us. But I was listening to this church podcast, and the preacher said, we can't, in the grand scheme of life, there's only one thing we can really control, and it's what we focus on. So I don't know which one of you guys' circumstances, but day by day, let's not focus on what's wrong. Let's focus on what we can make right. And just, again, thank you guys for everything you've done for me. Thank you.
I want to say, too, as a first-generation college student myself, that those of us that work in the center who also identify with those values and experiences, that's why we do what we do in the center. We all remember what it was like to be that undergraduate student that didn't know where to go, didn't know who to talk to, needed a snack, needed a hug, needed some advice, someone to help them read a form, those types of things, de-escalate fears and all of that. And so really that's why we do this work. So it's honestly our pleasure to help you, guide you along, help you change the future for yourselves and your families. So we're so proud of you all.
Yeah, I wanna kind of piggyback off Jamie, because as a first generation college student myself, I just want you all to really think about the new legacy that is being created now. Because from here on out, it will be forever different. I am so excited for every single one of you that are here, and even the folks that couldn't join us tonight, because I'm not that far out of all of the hard work that it took to get to where you are now. I'm so proud of every single one of you, and to see your faces this evening is such a joy, and it is truly our honor to get to support all of you who are graduating and all that will come after you. So thank you and congratulations.
We have a couple more minutes before our webinar license expires. So if anyone has any last things to share with folks, we'll give you a chance, but we will wrap it up in about 5 minutes.
Y'all, I just wanted to say that this group in particular has a really special place in my heart, because you all, many of you started your first year at the same time that I started my first year. And so it's really been such an honor to see you all grow, and even if you started before me, but still being able to see you grow into the wonderful people that you are and seeing all the wonderful things that you're doing. I truly cannot wait to see how you are all going into the world to impact it in wonderful ways. So please, like, we really truly mean this. Please stay in touch. You have our emails. You know where to find us. We want to hear from you. We want to continue to celebrate you even as alumni. And there are going to be opportunities where you all can come back and share your experience. So I highly encourage you to take advantage of that. But know that we will miss you so much. So much.
Hi, everyone. This is Rosa from the Nicholas Academic Center. So I just wanted to drop in and say a quick, huge thank you to both Jamie and Kanitsa and Yahaira and all the team at the Center for Scholars. I am so happy and so proud of the fact that our kids found within you all a family, and that you were able to embrace them and guide them when it got tough. You know, they come back and visit, and they tell us about the amazing things that they get to do with you all, from getting to sleep when they're tired in between midterms and finals, to getting a banana when they are hungry, to just having somebody to hear them. So muchas gracias for taking care of them and making sure that they get to the finish line. It wouldn't have happened with all of your help. And thank you for putting this wonderful program together. I've been to a couple of these over the last 2 weeks, and I think yours is by far the best one that I've been to. It's just amazing. Thank you so much.
And I think in return, what I want to say is, you know, to the folks from NAC is thank you for trusting us with your scholars. And, you know, the same thing for Abrego Future Scholars, like, because of you, we have this beautiful, diverse environment that when you walk in, you can't help but to smile. Like, a lot of you used to like hang out right outside my office, and I would love hearing like your laughter, your jokes. Some of them were a little inappropriate, and so I would walk out and be like, that's not scholar language. But I even love having those little parent moments with you. And so we're gonna miss you so much. You're leaving a beautiful legacy. And for me, this group is super special because I'm first gen too. So I know exactly what you're, not exactly maybe, but I know what your journey looks like. I know the struggle, I know the challenges, and I also know the bittersweet feeling you feel when you achieve something this big. So I hope you really do take the time to celebrate at home or wherever you are with your loved ones. Make sure that you recognize what you've done today, what you achieved this semester. And you talk about it with as many people as you can. You share it, because that's really important. Own it, own your greatness, own the awesome things that you're doing, and share it with the world, because people need to hear these things. So I'm so, so proud of all of you. Congratulations.
I wanted to say a few words myself, and I wanted to say thank you for the Center for Scholars for everything that you guys have done for us. And I want to say a special thanks to Jamie, Kenitza, and Danny for helping me throughout my entire 4 years. You guys have impacted me more than you guys think. And whenever I look back at my undergraduates in Cal State Fullerton, I will definitely remember the Abrego Future Scholars. It's definitely been more than just a commuting school. I've participated in many clubs, and I always fall back on the Abrego Future Scholars. You guys have made it very comfortable and welcoming every time, and thank you so much. Also, congratulations for everyone. We did it. We're graduating.
All right, everyone, thank you for joining us. It's now 7:30, and our webinar license is about to expire. We are so glad you were able to join us. We're so proud of you. We hope to see you all soon, that you get to wear your regalia, come back, take campus photos as soon as we're able to do so. We know you need to see you walking around in those caps and gowns with your sashes and all that fun stuff. So we look forward to seeing you all soon and celebrating you. Thank you so much for joining us, everyone. Bye. Congratulations.
Thank you for everything.
Yes. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye. You're welcome. We're so proud of y'all.